New Bond Street. It is a mecca for luxury lovers seeking the finest jewelry, designer clothes, and elegant goods. Shoppers come from far and wide to this London destination, famed for its wealth of prestigious retailers. On the surface, New Bond Street looks as glitzy and vibrant as ever. But all is not well in the luxury goods market. After several years of mounting revenues and profits, there are signs that the sector is finally cooling. The latest results from brands including Burberry and LVMH, the world's largest luxury group by sales, whose portfolio includes Louis Vuitton, all point to a slowdown in the market.
Burberry has reported a strong first half of its financial year, but it is warning that the conditions could become much tougher for global luxury goods groups in the remainder of the year. Mulberry, on the other hand, has seen its first half sales fall by 17%, and it is warning that its full-year profits will be significantly down.
One source of concern for luxury retailers is the sluggish global economy. The IMF recently cut its forecast for global growth, and Managing Director Christine Lagarde highlighted the lagging emerging economies, which have been a strong source of demand for luxury goods in recent years.
In the emerging market economies, you have reasonably strong, although slower, growth out of China, better than what we had thought out of India, and clearly a major slowdown in countries like Brazil and Russia.
But there are other factors adding to retailers' concern.
We've had a perfect storm for the luxury industry. We've had sanctions involving Russia, protests in Hong Kong, concerns about the Ebola outbreak. That's all affecting the traveling luxury consumer, which many global brands have come to rely on over the past few years.
Are these just speed bumps for the sector, or are luxury retailers grappling with a longer-term decline?
I think there are a few concerns playing out with luxury goods. First of all, I think emerging markets have slowed somewhat, notably China slowed somewhat, and within that, the Chinese government has been clamping down on ostentatious consumption. That's not helping Chinese basically binge on to bling as such. I think the other thing that's happened as well is the Chinese have become a lot more discerning, and they love the very high end. They want to be more exclusive in terms of what they buy. And or there's big growth in terms of affordable luxury. I think the middle of luxury is starting to get a little bit boring to many consumers, which is why the likes of Louis Vuitton, Prada, almost becoming too common, and that's hurting. So I think overall the sector has slowed somewhat, I think continues to gently slow, but I do think this is as much about brand fatigue and people struggling, frankly, with very big price increases in this sector, and perhaps perceiving that they're not getting enough value or enough exclusivity to pay up for those price increases.
So it's not just the emerging economies that luxury brands have to worry about. They'll need to adapt to the needs of ever more discerning consumers to convince them that the gold and the glitz is worth their money. Vanessa Kortekaas, Financial Times, London.